Hey everybody, and welcome to another video here on Living Room Gear Demos. Ever so often when I demo, let's say an amp, a pedal or a guitar, I do produced tracks on this channel. And I get asked a lot on how I mix those songs. So I thought I wanted to make this video and show you how I do it. And if you are experienced with the mixing and recording, guitars especially, maybe this video is not for you. It's more a beginner's tutorial because I'm far from an experienced producer. So this is more of a dummy guide from a dummy. Let's get to it. I want to show you a couple of tricks that I have learned up and through the years when recording guitar and mixing. First thing that I find important is to get something else than just headphones when mixing. I did that for many years, and to me that worked well, I thought at least, until I got some real studio monitors. Looking back now, I kind of see that it's almost impossible to get the levels right and to get the feel right when just using headphones. And that kind of leads me over to the sponsor of this video, which is Dyne Audio, that sent me a couple of really good studio monitors, the Lyd 7s. I've been using a different brand for many years, a cheaper brand. I never really experienced any problems with them until I got these new ones, and I kind of understood how important it is to have good studio monitors. So now I have the Lyd 7s and I find them a lot better to mix on. For me especially, I find that controlling the bass and the lower frequencies is a lot more easy. And when I'm listening to the mix on different devices, it sounds much more right. So the first tip is to get some decent studio monitors. You can use headphones from time to time, but get some good studio monitors and you will probably thank me later. Second tip is for recording guitars. If you are recording more than one track, be sure to use something different on the other track. By that, I mean if you're using the same guitar, the same amp, and the same mic on the second track, you will probably get into some phase issues. So either change or move the microphone, change the speaker. That means you can change the cab if you have a head and a cab. Use a different amp, that's what I prefer to do. And probably use a different guitar if you have that. When it comes to mic placement, I've spent many hours to try to get that right. I'm not like quite there yet, but I'm getting better. One thing that I do that most people are not doing, at least from what I can see on photos and tutorials online, is to move away the mic from the cab, maybe like this. I find that it captures a bit more of what I want to hear and it gets less bright when I'm doing that. When you are recording guitars, of course you want to make sure that you're capturing something that you already like. So you should capture a guitar tone that actually sounds good. But still, after that, you want to put on a high pass filter. I usually do that in my standard EQ plugin that comes with my DAW. So a cut usually around 100 Hertz, and I also cut the higher frequencies around 8,500 Hertz. When doing this, you're kind of removing frequencies that you really can't hear, but you're cleaning up the mix quite a lot. So that's something that you should do. When recording heavier stuff and rock stuff, I've tried many times to do quad tracking. That means that you're doing two guitars on the left side and two guitars on the right side. And even when it's songs that I've written, I find it too hard to play them good enough so that it's worth actually quad tracking them. I would recommend to you that you only record one guitar on the left side and one on the right side. That's usually more than enough. You still have to play tight, of course, but it's not nearly as impossible as doing chord tracks. If you are recording DIs, either to use with amp plugins or to use later with reamping, make sure to have clean and good DI. You don't want any spikes in there. Make sure to record them at a decent level, and it will be a lot easier when working with them later. And the next tip is a plugin that I want to recommend to you. I actually got a tip from two different friends of mine that are both engineers and producers, and it's a plugin called Sood from Awake Sound or something like that from Finland. It's a really good plugin if you feel that your guitar is a tiny bit bright. I'm actually way too stupid to explain to you what the plugin does, but check it out and you will see how good it is. When doing these songs, I always use software drums, and this is a tip that I got from someone I know as well, and that is to parallel compress the drums, and that will make the drums sound a lot fatter and tighter and everything you want with drums. I'll link down below to an article here online that shows you how to do that very easily. So that's all my tips for recording guitar and mixing stuff. Hope you enjoyed, and thanks a lot again to Dyne Audio for sponsoring this video. Check them out down below. I really recommend the Lead 7s. If it's someone you should trust when it comes to sound, it's people from Denmark. That's something that I've learned up and through the years. Check out my merch store. I will also link that down below. And yeah, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.